Hello everyone, welcome to the second video in the series Medium Access Methods in a Wireless LAN Network. In this video, we are going to talk about the next important concept in medium access control, which is something called as interframe spaces. Now, in the last video, we talked about how clear channel assessment becomes a very important step to determine whether the medium is busy or idle. Now, once clear channel assessment is complete, the station can't immediately transmit a frame. The station has to wait for a certain time interval, and that time interval is called an interframe space. The interframe space again depends on two factors. One is the PHY of the medium, and second is the type of the frame being transmitted. Every type of frame has a different interframe space. Interframe space is not to be confused with COS, because that essentially comes in the EDCA section, which we are going to talk about probably in the next video. But it is more about giving different time intervals for transmitting different types of frames. Let's look at some of the common interframe spaces that we have. So SIFS here stands for short interframe space. PIFS stands for priority interframe space. DIFS stands for DCF interframe space, and EIFS stands for extended interframe space. The reason that I have marked this in this order is to denote the length of each of these interframe space. SIFS is the shortest of the interframe spaces, following by PIFS. Then DIFS is the longest of the interframe spaces, and then it's again followed by the extended interframe space. So EIFS becomes the longest and SIFS becomes the shortest interframe space. Now, there is one more additional type of interframe space called as reduced interframe space, or RIFS, which is even more shorter than the SIFS. However, we won't be discussing this today. So RIFS was introduced as part of the WLAN N standard, but was quickly deprecated in the WLAN AC standard. This is still used in some other Wi-Fi standards, but not very common to see in a normal BSS. Let's look at the first type of interframe space and talk a little more in detail about it, which is the short interframe space, or SIFS. Now, when is a short interframe space used, or for what type of frames does this type of interframe space apply? The most common thing is ACK frames. So an acknowledgement frame is always sent after a SIFS or a SIFS. CTS frames in response to an RTS follows an SIFS or is sent after an SIFS interval. The data frame which follows a CTS again, right? It is again sent after an SIFS interval. And in a fragmentation burst, the individual frames that are sent inside a fragmentation burst also use an SIFS interval. So as one can imagine, the SIFS frames are used where priority or communication should be given priority, like the acknowledgement frame or the CTS frame or the individual frames inside a fragment burst. So they get the most amount of priority by using the short interframe space. Let's look at some of the common PHYs and what is the short interframe space, what are the short interframe space values for those PHYs. Now, starting from DSS, the short interframe space value is 10 microseconds. OFDM is 16 microseconds. HR DSS is 10 microseconds. ERP again is 10. HT and HE can be a combination of 10 or 16. So the 10 here is for the for the 2.4 gigahertz spectrum, and the 16 here is for the 5 gigahertz spectrum. Similarly, in HE10 is for the 2.4 gigahertz world, and 16 is for the 5 gigahertz. So VHD again, it is 16 microseconds. Going forward, let's talk something about the priority interframe space, which is the second longest interframe space after the SIFS. So a priority interframe space is generally seen when we have transmit beam forming, especially while transmitting the NDP frames used for transmit beam forming. It is also used for frames which announce a channel switch of the BSS or channel switch announcement frames, TIM frames, etc. Now, the PIFS being longer than the SIFS, there is a formula to calculate the PIFS. So the PIFS is one SIFS plus one slot time. Now the slot time is a value which is pretty much defined for different PHYs, as you can see in the table. So the slot times are used to calculate the other interframe spaces too, right? So in this case, a PIFS being one slot time plus one SIFS, that would mean that the PIFS interval for a DSS PHY is 20, which is the slot time for DSS, plus a 10 microsecond, which is nothing but the SIFS value for the DSS PHY, as we saw in the previous slide. So the PIFS value for the DSS PHY would be 30 microseconds. The same logic applies to rest of the PHYs. So essentially it is one slot time plus one SIFS interval, which makes it inevitably larger than the SIFS interval in every case. Now, moving ahead, we are at the third type of interframe space, which is the DCF interframe space. The DCF interframe space is now the longest of the interframe space discussed so far, at least among the last three types of frames. Now, how does it make it the longest, right? So similar to how we saw PIFS being calculated, DIFS is calculated as one SIFS interval plus two times the slot time of the PHY. The DIFS interval is used, or the DIFS interval is used, for transmission of standard data frames. Now, as it is evident from the calculation here, the DIFS is the longest among the rest of the two frames, which also means that frames which are sent following an SIFS and a PIFS will almost always be, will get the medium, or will always be able to send it more frequently than a standard data frame. Let us also look at a small example of how this is calculated in real world. Let's, for example, take OFDM as a PHY. Now, OFDM has a slot time of 9 microseconds, and it has a SIFS interval, or a short interframe space interval, of 16 microseconds. So going by the formula here, it is 2 times 9 plus 16, which is 16 plus 18, gives you a 34 microsecond interval to transmit a standard data frame on OFDM. Now, coming to the last part of the discussion today, there are two additional types of interframe spaces, one of it which we have already discussed in the first slide, which is an extended interframe space. The other one that we're going to talk about is the arbitration interframe space. We won't be talking about this much in this video because it is primarily used in EDCA. Now, The AIFS or the arbitration interframe space are used to transmit frames like PS pole or the power save mechanisms, RTS, CTS, and block acts. Whereas the extended interframe space are primarily used to transmit frames preceding or following a frame which has a bad FCS or a broken frame or a malformed frame, which makes EIFS also the longest interframe space to be available, and which is calculated as one SIFS interval plus the transmit time required to transmit one ACK frame plus an entire DIFS. So evidently this becomes the largest type of interframe space, and it is exclusively used to respond to a bad frame or a corrupted frame. I hope the concept of interframe spaces, the different types of interframe spaces, what are the different types of frames which use these IFS values are clear in this video. Going ahead, in the next video, we are going to talk about the next topic which comes in sequence, and that is EDCA. So this will be an interesting topic, and we'll talk more about arbitrary interframe space in EDCA and how this facilitates in the implementation of quality of service. Thank you for tuning in. See you in the next video. Thanks.